Here is a clear explanation of strings in Python, with code examples, a quiz, the answers, and a code review. Okay, so how do we deal with text in Python? One of the main data types is a string. So we're going to look at how you print strings, how you put them together, the things that you can do with strings in Python, how you can access parts of them, and then slice these parts from the string, called slicing. So to print a string, we can just use the normal syntax with either double quotes or single quotes. The main thing to remember is, if the string's got a single quote or a double quote inside it, then you use the opposite one. So if it has a single quote, use double quotes. If it has double quotes, then we use single quotes. If you'll get this wrong, and like in this example, there's a double quote used inside the string, then you'll get a syntax error. You can print different things inside a string, so you have different characters, such as question marks, exclamation marks, like all types of punctuation, and numbers. Here we have the number 7, but it's actually a string of the character 7, which is not the same as an integer. So how do we add them together? We use concatenation. So if you want to add strings together, you can just use the plus symbol. So here is a string, and here's another string 7. We can add them together, and the output is, here is the string 7. We can also multiply strings, and that will multiply the string and repeat it that many times. So for example, we have here is a string times 3, so it prints here is a string, here is a string, here is a string. Be careful though, in this example, y is not a string, it's a number 7. And if you're trying to add a string, then sometimes it doesn't work. So in this example, we've got here is a string plus 7, and that won't work because one's a string and one's an integer. So what can we do with strings in Python? There are several functions that are already built in. One common one is length, which uses the term len, L-E-N. So we have the string inside it. So here we have length of x, len x in brackets. So hello has 5 characters. The length is 5. We have several features that can change the text. So here we've got upper, will change the letters to uppercase. Here we've got lower, that will change the letters to lowercase. Here we've got replace. So the word hello has 2 L's and now be replaced by the letter O. So the output is H-E-O-O-O. Here we have a string 1, 2, 3, 4 separated by commas. We can split that, and because it's split into parts, it goes into something called a list. If we print that list, we'll see the parts of the string in between the commas. So here we have 1, 2, 3, and 4. If we don't use anything inside the split, it will split by the spaces. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we have a space, then 1, 2, 3, 4 without commas, a space, and anything here. So that will separate those words as well. So you can see the output there. It will separate and split the string by the spaces. Another function that's already in Python is strip. So here we have hello, but it has some spaces before and after. So if we print strip, it will just print the hello. If we use L-strip, which is short for left strip, it will strip the spaces before the hello. If we use R-strip, it will split the spaces from behind. So if you see the output, the first one is hello with no spaces, the second one is hello with spaces after, and the third one has spaces before. The final one we're looking at is find. So here we're looking for the letter L, and using find will find the place where the first L is. Now we start at 0, so H-E-L will be number 2. So that's find. That uses something called indexing. So if we look at an example of a string hello world, we can access each character by a number that starts off with the first letter, which will be accessed by 0. So here we have a string a string hello world in a variable x. So if we say x0, that will print h. x6 will be the sixth character, so we have hello space and w. Remember, they start off at 0, so x6 will be w. And the other example, we have x0 plus x1, so we have the first characters h and e. If we try to find x11, because we think there's 11 characters, we'll have an error message, because remember, we started at 0. So we'd actually finish at x10. So we can use this to take parts of the string, substrings, and this is called slicing. So here we have x0 to 7, so that's hello space w, so we'd output hello space w. x0 to x1 is just the first character, and if we start at the beginning, we don't need to put the 0. So we have a number colon number for a substring, but if we start at the beginning, we don't need to put the 0. So we, in this example, we just have the colon and 7. So that would bring up to character 7, which is w, hello space w. We can also print to the end. So here we have print 3 to 8, which is lo space wo. And then we have 3 to 11, which is the end, that will print from lo to the end. So lo space world. Again, if we're going to use a substring that goes to the end, we don't need to put the last number 11 in. So in the last example, we've got 3 colon and then it's left blank, and that will print the string from the third character to the end, which is lo space world. So as you may guess, if we wanted to copy the whole string, instead of putting the number from the beginning to the end, 0, 11, we can actually just use the colon by itself, and that will make a copy. One method that I suggest to students that they use is using boxes around the characters and then numbering them. In this example, if you want to just write the boxes as the continuous string and then start off with 0, you can see it makes it much easier to understand where the string is sliced from and where it's sliced to. So in the example, 3 to the end is quite straightforward, DEF, from the beginning to 3, ABC, and even something in between 2 to 5, CDE. So it is quite simple if you write down the boxes, if you like, where the characters are and the numbers. So in an exam, I certainly suggest that students do that. Another way of doing it is to think, oh, I'm going to slice, so therefore you could take a slice of a pie, if you like. So here we have the same examples, A, B, C, D, E, F, but these actually use a pie, starting at 0, going round to 6 at the end. So here we still see the same examples, 3 to the end, D, E, F, to the beginning to 3, A, B, C, and from 2 to 5, we can see C, D, E. So these are two graphical ways that we can ensure we get the right substring. Okay, so let's test your knowledge with some questions. So question 1. You print the string 1 to 1 7 times. That's question 1. Question 2. Can you print a list that's created by splitting the string 98765 with colons in between the numbers by those colons? So you're going to split that string by the colon. That's question 2. Question 3. You've got a string A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, and I want you to print the letters from C to J. So you're going to slice that string and print C to J. That was question 3. Question 4, you've got the string hello, and I want you to print it, but with a capital H, an uppercase H, at the beginning. That's question 4. Question 5 has got the string hello world, And I want you to print the hello with an uppercase H, but also the second word, world, I want you to print with an uppercase W. That's question 5. So, how did you do? Let's have a look at the answers. Well, if you want to print 1-2-1 7 times, we can just print the string 1-2-1 times by 7. So that's quite straightforward. And the output will have 1-2-1 7 times on the same line. So that's the solution to question 1. Question 2, we want to split the string. So we're going to use the built-in function split. So here we've got the string and I've put it in x. Then we've got a list called a list, and that's going to equal x dot split, and we're going to split it by the colon. So we put the colon in double quotation marks, and then we print that, and then we have the output 98765, which is actually a list, so you'll see the square brackets. That was question 2. Question 3, we're going to slice the string from the letters from A to P, from C to J. Now C will be from 2, because we start and we have 0, 1 and 2, so it's 2 to 10. So did you get that right? So that's slicing from 2 to 10. That was question 3. Question 4, we have the string hello and we want to print it with the first letter as an uppercase. So we use two methods here. First of all, we use the slicing. So we have x0, the first letter, and also we're going to use a built-in function upper. So we have the first letter dot upper, that makes the uppercase H, and we add to that, so we're concatenating the rest of the string, which will be from 1 to the end. So you don't need to know how many's in the, you just put 1 colon and that will print the rest from position 1. So that was the answer to question 4. Question 5, we have, similar to question 4 but a bit more involved, we have hello world and we want to print it with the capital H and W. So again we use the uppercase for the first letter, we use uppercase for the 6th letter, which is W, and we add bit in between, which is x1 to 6, so that's the slice 1 to 6, and the final slice is from position 7, so 7 colon. So we add 4 parts of the string. The first part made an uppercase, the second part between the H and the W, the third part, which is the W, made to uppercase, and the final part of the string. That's the solution to question 5. Okay, great, we've come to the end. So here's a question for you. If you try to copy some text from the web and you put it into a string, when you use split, does it do what you expect? Try it and see if it does. Okay, if you find any interesting results, use a comment and put it below. Please remember to subscribe if you haven't done already. Okay, thanks for watching, and finally here's all of the code, then the code review.